Namaskar. The heartbeat is first heard in the developing embryo in mother's womb. The rhythmic beat continues day and night and stops only at the time of death. Our heart is an extremely vital organ which pumps blood throughout our body. When we talk about heart problems, we think of high cholesterol, hypertension, obesity, and many more such things. Yes, each of these factors are going to contribute for heart diseases. But one major factor which we ignore, which we don't register, is our stress. In the absence of all other factors also, stress alone can create heart attack. Stress is known to alter the chemistry of our body directly. It causes changes in circulating catecholamine and cortisol in our system. It affects indirectly our blood pressure, our cholesterol level, our blood sugar level, and our lipid profiles. Stress has become a very common term in our today's society. Even children say they are under stress. Children are required to cope up with a stress such as exam stress. There are many young adults who don't smoke or drink, yet they have heart attack because of stress, especially the stress caused by long hours of work or work-related many reasons. A certain amount of stress is required to stay active and healthy, but if that proportion is higher, then it causes attack. Because excess stress increases workload on heart. As there is an increase in the heart rate and oxygen consumption, the mind and body functions in unison. The imbalance in the mind triggers the harmful chemical processes at the physical level, and this results in sickness and diseases. But with the help of yoga technique, person can develop a positive state of mind and naturally help a positive state in the body. The studies have shown that yoga and pranayama instantly increase in the peripheral blood oxygen concentration. Today, I am going to share a very effective pranayama called as Rechaka or long exhalation. This will help you to develop a let-go feeling and relieve stress, which in turn will keep your heart healthy. While practicing pranayama, you focus on your breathing rhythm and go away from all the worries and tension of the world. This stress-free state of mind evokes relaxed response in which parasympathetic nerve overrides sympathetic nerve activity. As a technique, pranayama can be a complex form of breathing. But the nature of practice is slow and deep breathing. Each time when person takes a long inhalation, the diaphragm is pulled down and stretched, during which the extra 90% lung, which is dormant, is activated and more oxygen is absorbed in our body. In addition, two large vessels, aorta, carrying blood from heart to inferior vena cava, is relaxed as the diaphragmatic walls are stretched out. This reduces the workload of the heart pumping chamber. So, here, how you should practice Rechaka. Sit straight in any meditative pose which you feel comfortable. Keep your spine straight, head straight, and your both palms on your knee, palm facing downwards. Close your eyes or keep your eyes open and fix your gaze on one point. Inhale slowly and continuously for 3 seconds. And now slowly and without jerk, start exhaling and continue it for 6 seconds. The emphasis is on prolonged exhalation. Take a few normal breaths before the next round. Practice 4 to 5 rounds with the pause in between each round. You can increase the duration of exhalation go on exhaling longer and longer as you practice regularly. And when you increase the exhalation, try to keep inhalation in proportion. It is like 2-4 or 3-6 or 4-8. This is how you should manage. Also, this excellent pranayama, which can really help you keep your heart healthy. There are some limitations of who cannot perform this pranayama. This includes people who have just got out of heart attack. Don't do this pranayama for a month. Similarly, when the blood pressure is already too high, don't do this pranayama till it comes to normal. Also, follow some precaution before practicing pranayama. Never practice pranayama if you are too tired. Before doing pranayama, first person should relax in shavasana and then only person should do pranayama. So, do practice this pranayama regularly. This pranayama could be practiced by even saying om or by humming. Take a breath and start saying om. Or just do humming. Breathe in, close your mouth and all these techniques are nothing else but long exhalation. These techniques work wonders. It really brings your mind into a very calm state. You know, mind gets into an alpha wave state and you are very happy and peaceful. When you start practicing like this, you would learn to remain stress-free throughout the day also. And so, here you will be helping your heart, helping the functioning of your heart, and you will always prevent all these problems related to heart. So take charge of yourself, take care, and do this regularly. Namaskar.